is Dr. Susan Brown, your bone health nutritionist, and I want to welcome everyone in the Better Bones community to our discussion today. Today, we're going to talk about a topic that brings up a lot of controversy, a lot of questions, a lot of confusion, and that topic is strontium, for the use of strontium for bone health. We're going to take a deep dive into strontium and look at the many issues and try to have all our listeners and all our community understand better about strontium and its use in bone health. Number one, strontium is an element. It's naturally occurring in the environment in small amounts in water and in some foods. It has been shown to be very similar to calcium in many of its properties. In fact, it's in the periodic table very near calcium, and it has certain properties that are shown to help bone formation. There is some confusion around strontium in that people are thinking of elemental strontium, that is the basic element, like a calcium, magnesium, zinc. But then you have the drug strontium, which is strontium renalate, also called protelose. And this is a drug that was developed in France. It's used in Europe. It's not used in the United States. The difference is that elemental strontium, like we receive in our diet, we get in very low doses. This drug strontium is a very high dose, and we're going to talk about that in a second. And then, of course, there's strontium 90, which is a radioactive byproduct of nuclear reactivities and nuclear experiments. This is not what we're talking about, and it's never a nutritional factor at all. So when you talk about strontium 90, as I mentioned, it's a hazardous radioactive nuclear byproduct. It's not found in food or drinks. We're not even considering it in our talk today. When you talk about elemental strontium as a natural part of the earth crust that shows up in the water and somewhat in the food, we know that it promotes the formation of healthy bones and teeth, even though it's in very small quantities in our diet, and that it works with calcium and other nutrients in promoting bone health. And in fact, it was because of its known benefit to bone that the researchers went on to develop a drug around strontium. One of the difficult situations is that strontium in high dose can be detrimental, and we're going to see it's used in high dose when it comes to this drug of strontium. So just to get an idea about the strontium doses, in the food you might have from 10, we put 10 to 50, but really you have very little strontium in the food, maybe 10 or 20 milligrams. Doses higher than that can range from any place from 50 milligrams up to, say, 700 milligrams. And in fact, at this high end is where they have started using strontium as a drug therapy. This strontium relenate, a synthetic sort of strontium that was developed as a bone drug, is very high dose. So what we want everyone to distinguish is the strontium that's used in bone building products and certainly in the Better Bones Builder and other nutrients we use here at the Center for Better Bones is a very low amount of strontium, somewhat similar to what you get in your diet at this very low end. When you get into the pharmacological doses, this is what they have developed for drug therapy because it had some interesting potential of actually halting bone breakdown and building bone mass. Now that they've been using this drug for over a decade, we're going to see what the research shows about the pros and the cons of this drug. But in the meanwhile, I want you to be very clear that the strontium we use in any nutrient supplement is a dietary dose, a low-dose strontium, very different. For example, with this high-dose strontium, you have to separate it from calcium if you want to get the benefit on bone, because the calcium and the strontium compete for absorption. This is why you'll see that the recommendation, if you happen to be using high-dose strontium like some of the supplement companies are selling today, you don't want to take it with calcium. You want to take it totally separate. And in Europe, they give it at night, at bedtime, in just one large dose, because you want to actually have the bone absorb some strontium atoms and not and displace some calcium. And that, they argue, gives a particular strength to bone. So that's not a natural therapy. It's kind of very unusual therapy, forcing the body to accept more strontium by giving very high strontium and separating it from calcium. Our interest is more with this low dose therapy, which is a food factor dose that's very helpful in building strong bones. But let's take another minute with this drug, because many people get confused thinking that strontium is a natural therapy in high dose when it's really a drug therapy. To make a drug, they had to develop a synthetic in Europe. You can't patent just an element that's well known. So they combined strontium with renolenic acid, and they made this drug, which is 680 milligrams of strontium. It's combined, as I say, with renolenic acid. It delivers a lot of strontium. And this research and the use of this drug began in 2004. So now we've had, you know, almost a decade and a half looking at this. We're going to see what they came up, what kind of safety factors, safety concerns they came up using this drug for bone health. It was found to modestly reduce osteoporotic fractures, and I'm sure the manufacturers of this had hoped that it would be more successful, but the European researchers are concluding that it modestly reduces osteoporotic fractures, this drug, Protalos. Now, as far as in the US, we cannot buy the drug strontium, so some creative marketers have developed very high dose strontium, which is either strontium carbonate or strontium citrate. Again, this is a manufactured product, but it is more of a, it's not a patentable form of strontium. And again, some individuals are using this high dose of 680 milligrams. What we're gonna say is that the drug therapy of strontium, the high dose strontium, which has been highly tested over 10, 11, 12, almost 15 years, now they've seen the benefits and they've seen the problems with it. And like with all drug therapies, after a certain number of years, they begin to discover the problems as you try to kind of tinker with the body's mechanism for maintaining bone and breaking down bone. In the case of strontium, you see that the researchers in Europe are saying it may cause a modest improvement in bone density and a modest reduction in fracture. And we're gonna look at that data in just a second. But it has been found now, after 15 years or so, it has been found to significantly increase the risk of heart problems and clots and nausea, diarrhea. So there's been some serious issues with using this high-dose strontium renolate, this drug form called Protalos of strontium. In Europe, just to look at the actual, what they did find for fracture reduction, using this high-dose drug strontium, they found it was very modest that the European agency that oversees these success of these drugs, they reported a sort of modest impact. For every 1,000 patient years that used this drug, there were five non-spinal fractures, like a wrist fracture or an arm fracture. That's for 1,000 patient years. The spinal fractures were reduced by 15, and the hip fractures were reduced by 0.4, not even a half of one. And so you'll see, this is why they say it's really relatively modest benefit on bone. Here at the Center for Better Bones, we're always saying, what are the natural ways we can build bone strength and prevent fracture, actually? And you'll see the drug therapy was not outstandingly successful. And what happened was it provided significant adverse effects to such an extent that the European agency, who oversees these problems, reported that for every 1,000 patient years, the same number of people, you would have 4 more cases of serious heart problems, 4 more cases of blood clots or blockages of blood vessels than you found in people who didn't use the drug. So the benefits were maybe 5 fractures reduced that were not wrist fractures, maybe 15 spinal fractures, maybe a half a hip fracture for that same number of people, and yet you created 4 serious heart situations, 4 serious clots or blockages. So the conclusion of the European agencies was that the risk of strontium, the strontium drug, the strontium renolate, outweighed the benefits, and they recommended suspending use of this drug. This was in 2014. That was their recommendation. Let's not use it. It's too dangerous. It has very little benefit. Then there was some negotiation, some things going on, and this was reconsidered. And then later in that year, 2014, the European Committee, the same committee that had reviewed it before, decided that it could be used but only by patients who could not tolerate any other osteoporosis drugs. It would sort of be a last-ditch effort, and requiring that patients using strontium be carefully monitored. So they say, doesn't really prevent a lot of fractures, it has some significant side effects, let's use it. We'll allow it to be used, but only in cases where nothing else is able to be effective or can be tolerated by the patients. And they also said if you have a history of heart or circulatory problems, you're not allowed to use the medication at all. So it sort of took the winds out of the sails of this strontium relenate, high dose strontium drug therapy. Now, many of my clients say, okay, that's the drug. What about natural strontium? What about this company that's telling me to take 680 milligrams of strontium citrate or strontium carbonate, that's going to build my bone? Well, the situation is, we know that there have been no studies on this natural therapy. You know, only time we see studies on fracture reduction and risk factors are when there's a big money behind it. And that happens when it's a drug and it's patented and they can make a considerable income. So with strontium citrate or strontium carbonate, what we can buy here in this country, in the United States, it's sold as a supplement. It's a manufactured form of strontium, either strontium citrate or strontium carbonate. There are no clinical trials, of course. And in fact, there's only anecdotes of people saying, well, I used the strontium, I gained so much bone density, or I didn't gain bone density. There's been no studies as to its effectiveness in fracture reduction or to the safety of this high-dose strontium. And of course, at the Center for Better Bones, we try to deal with therapies in the most natural fashion that we can. And so we'd be a little shy of this extremely high dose therapy, putting all that much strontium through the body, how it affects the kidney, how it affects other parts of the body. In short, the risk-benefit ratio of high dose strontium, like we can buy in this country as supplements, is totally unknown. And one thing we do know is that when you stop using this high dose strontium, like similar to any other bone drug, when you stop using it, you're going to lose everything you gained within a few years if you do not use another bone drug, because these drugs artificially stimulate the body to build bone. But when you stop using the drug, the benefits are lost. And in fact, with strontium, many of you may know that it actually deposits in bone, and it actually makes bone on the x-ray look stronger than it really is. So you have to there is a factor that they calculate to see if they say, oh, you had a 5% increase in bone density, it may only really be 3% given the fact that there's an artifact of strontium. So the long and the short of it is, we know that the drug high-dose strontium, the 680 milligrams that's used in strontium renalate and called the proteolose drug in Europe, we know that drug has a small benefit on fracture reduction, but it also has a considerable many negative heart effects on the heart, the circulatory system, and it's been suggested that it's not really safe to use. We know nothing about high-dose natural strontium like you might be able to buy here. So just be aware when you get your supplement, a dietary dose of strontium, we consider maybe up to 50 milligrams that we might use in a supplement, or 10, 20 milligrams. That's one thing. That's more the dietary range. When you get into a high dose, it's really uncharted territories about any adverse effects that there might be. The byline we say here at the Center for Better Bones, and this is so important to remember, if you have a problem that you're losing bone density, or that your bones are weakened, or that you're fracturing needlessly, the most important thing is to find out why the bones are weak. We say every bone weakness has a cause. So you want to find out why the bones are weak and what you can actually do to uncover that problem and then resolve that problem. So take it to heart, work on the Better Bones, Better Body program. If you do use strontium, just work with your doctors to make sure that you're having some effectiveness of it, and try to do every step of the Better Bones, Better Body program to use all the other nutrients, and also to be sure to look for secondary causes of bone loss. Okay, I hope this straightens out the story with strontium. One last thing, if you're using a small dietary dose of strontium, you do not need to, in any way, shape, or form, separate it from calcium. It's just a high dose you have to separate. Thanks a lot.